Okay, so Halloween is near, and I've been looking for a horror game in the market to play that is not about Cthulhu, and here I found A Touch of Evil. Thank you to Facebook groups like Solo Board Gamers. I found this game that is by Flying Frog Productions. They are the ones who made Last Night on Earth. Basically the same art style. They are stills from the movie. But they have good makeup here. See, you wouldn't even notice that this is makeup. Well, obviously it's makeup, but yeah, so let's open A Touch of Evil. So this is the board. This is the cover. This is the back. As you can see, this is the components here. Components breakdown. It's for 2 to 8 players. That's unusual. But okay, let's see how good the components are. I don't know the rules of the game. I just heard that it's a good horror game, and it's not about Cthulhu. I don't hate Cthulhu. I just there's just too much Cthulhu themed games in the market that is sometimes unnecessary. Okay, there we go. Some Facebook users recommended Mansions of Madness. Some people in my group recommended Betrayal at the House on the Hill. But I don't like those. Honestly, I just don't. But this one, maybe I might like it. Because I love Talisman. Yeah, that's unusual, but I do. So let's see. Let's look inside the box. Here we have the rule book. Rulebook, how many pages? It's not a thin rulebook, so I have a lot of reading to do. Up to what page? 27 page rulebook. And yeah, explanation, how to play. I heard this is soloable, so I can play solo whenever. I can play solo to learn the rules before I introduce it to the group. Okay. The tokens. This looks like their characters. Oh, Franklin, a dog. Franklin. Militia. Oh, it's two-sided. This is transformation. Wait. Look, it's way over the line, transformation. And I don't like that. Not at all. It's not even centered. Why is it like that? Everything is not centered. What the hell? See? What copy did I get? Anyway. I'm not OC, but I hate seeing things like this. Anyway, I'm gonna punch it later. I hope the rest of the tokens are centered. Okay, so this is centered. This looks centered. These are the wound tokens. Another militia. Not centered. The horseman, the scarecrow, the werewolf, and the vampire. So these are the four villains, and this is the, I don't know, like a marker, maybe a tracker for the threat. So this is the moon tokens. These are the monsters, I believe, like a minion or something. Succubus, wolves, bats, walking dead, ghost soldiers, Barges Hound, Rat's Nest, Feral King, and the Locust Swarm. Same here. Spectre and Digging Trees. We have crows on the back. We have rats, bees, crow on the back on the other side, and on the other side there are rats. And this one, highwayman, on the other side, specter, highwayman, assassin, and living tree. Rat's nest behind feral king, and they're back to back. So I think it's the same. Yeah, they're back to back. So these are the minions. Next are blue tokens. I think these are the investigation tokens. I believe so. 5, 10, yeah, there's a lot. And this is flying frog. Yeah, a flying frog. Maybe this first player marker, I don't know. This is the board. I'm gonna open it later. Vampire Minion. Ooh. Nice quality cardboard. So this is the Vampire Minion chart. Vampire Minion chart. Werewolf Minion chart. Scarecrow Minion chart. And Spectral Horseman Minion chart. Good quality. Not the same as I've heard from some, but it can't be that I got a fake copy. That can't be. And what is this? It includes a CD soundtrack, game soundtrack, featuring original music by Mary Beth Magallanes. You've come to see us. Oh, nice. I'm gonna try this on later. Why don't we open the board? Why don't we open the board, huh? Just put it aside first. And it is a small board. It's a small board. Much smaller than pandemic board, I believe. But I cannot accurately tell. Okay, so we have a town hall here. I'm gonna do a zoom. Town hall, windmill, the manor, windmill, town hall, old woods, marsh, and abandoned keep. So those are 1, 2, 3, 4 corner location. And some other locations like fields and marsh, cover bridge. And then we have the town hall, which has different places like store, blacksmith, church, doctor's office, and magistrate's office. And that's it. That's I think it's pretty small. Some people say you need to have the first expansion to fully enjoy it. But maybe the base game still working. So okay, going back the main component, the minion charts, I'm gonna put it aside. Soundtrack, let me open it, see what's inside. It's a good thing they didn't include the VHS or a cassette tape. They included a CD, an actual CD. There's a smudge on the disc. Maybe you cannot see it, but I'm pretty sure I don't like what I'm seeing. Anyway, moving on. We have the miniatures. Let's go to the miniature one by one. So we have someone holding a skull with a gun on his right hand. Okay. That's someone holding a gun. And a skull. So someone who looks like a pirate holding a crossbow, a mini crossbow, and a sword. Let me focus on that. Okay. Someone holding a knife. Someone holding a rifle, a musket, if you must. Someone holding a lamp, a lantern, a lamp. Someone holding a Bible or books, and a pistol in the other hand. Someone holding an axe and a pistol. And then someone drinking from a cup. Okay, so let's talk about the quality of the miniature in the detail. These are plastic. These are good quality plastic. Somewhat flexible, a little rubbery. Closely. You can see the face, you can see the bottles on the coat, you can see the detail on the lamp, the lantern. So I can say. Is this the dice? Well, standard dice. It's embedded. It's good, but it's a standard white dye. They could have included black dye with like a skull for the one, but they didn't. But it's okay. How many dyes? 3, 6, 9, 12, 16. 16 dyes. Okay, so what are these? Similar to talisman character sheets, but this one is, these are tiles, good quality, strong, although unnecessary for me. You can put it on a cardboard and everything will be fine. People will still play it. So this is the Spectral Horseman villain. This is the Scarecrow villain. This is the werewolf. And this is the vampire. So these are the characters. Thomas the Courier. How can we know which one, which character uses which miniature? Because they don't show the full body. But this one is Thomas the Courier. Anne Marie, the school teacher, she probably is the one holding books. Inspector Cook, I don't know. Heinrich Cartwright, the drifter. Carl, the soldier, maybe the one holding the rifle. Katharina, the outlaw. Victor Danforth, the playwright. Isabella von Tuck, noble woman. And Spectral Horseman again. So these are the character, let's say tiles, character tiles. And let's go here, let's go to the cards. Let's open the card. Okay. Well, it sticks together and it's bent. This side. I bought this copy from Cool Stuff Inc. by the way, and for those who are interested to know. Anyway, let me just separate the cards quickly. Okay, I finally sorted out the cards, and it took me a while. All cards are stuck together, but I managed to do it. With that said, I don't want to complain anymore. To be honest, the cards are good quality. Are made of good quality. It's glossy. It's sturdy. It doesn't fold easily. It goes back to its original shape. If you shuffle it like that, you wouldn't even notice a bend. Okay, so it's good quality. Now let's go to the cards. Let's move on to the cards. So this is the reference cards for the game round, A Hero's Turn, explaining to you what you need to know. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Only six for six players, but some players can share because this is for 2 to 8 players. Next are just the Curse of the Werewolf. It's a special, I think this is a special effect of the werewolf dealing. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again, it's just 6 cards. So yeah, the werewolf is the art. I really like how they did the art here. It's basically just a still image of a real person with the makeup and some Photoshop editing. But some people doesn't like that, just hate it. But I like it, so I don't care about what they say. So these are the elders. They call it elders in the game. So this is Sophie the Midwife, Dr. Manning, Lord Hanbrook, Lady Hanbrook, Reverend Harding, Magistrate Croft. So they have special effects here, positive. But then if you find out their secret and then you find out that they're evil, you have to turn them back, and then they will fight with the villain against you. So they have, each elders have their secrets. So these are the secret deck. So you choose one and put it behind the, you choose one randomly, put it behind or under the elder. So an example of a secret card is On the Hunt. Reveal immediately. Place the marker, whatever. Where's the flavor text? There's no flavor text. This one has flavor text. Selfless martyr. With a strong purpose and sense of duty, that the town elder would go to any length to save their family, friends, or even a stranger. If this means dying for the cause, so be it. So yeah. But there are bad secrets that will make them side with a villain, but there are good secrets that will give them, like this, give you positive effect. Coward. Yeah. So those are the secrets card. The Lair card, I don't know what's the use of it yet, but I believe it allows you to look for the villain in its lair. So you can find them in the windmill, abandoned keep, and other places in the map that I just showed earlier. So those are the layer cards. Good quality, glossy, and I think it's coated with something. I don't know. It's town items. These are the items you can get from the town. Equip it and you will get a positive effect. So you can get a charmed relic, a horse, maybe it adds to your movement. Yeah, it adds to your movement. Horse, book of town history, healing herbs, musket, padded jacket, torch, etc. So those are the items. Silver shot, pistol. So those are the first set of cards. We have more cards here. Let me just take it out of the box and separate it. Mystery deck. Mystery deck and windmill. Okay, so it's mixed up again. So we have mystery here. Windmill. Okay, so windmill. treadmill. And anyway, I'm gonna split it up again. So I have the cards here separated already. I'm gonna open the other card to complete the location cards here and the event, so we can have it all on one shot. Probably I have to separate it again, so I'm gonna pause the video, separate the cards, sort it out, and display it on the screen. So this is what I'm doing to separate it. Okay, so now I think I feel that it's all separated. I'm gonna separate all the cards with the same card back. So these are the event, the manor, the main abandoned keep. Okay. It's here. Keep. Okay, so first we'll go to the mystery cards. What are those? I don't know, but I believe these are like the mythos at the end of Eldritch Horror's turn. Every turn you draw a card, things happen. So I think this is the same, but I'm not sure. So if you look closely at the art, it's well done, it's well edited, it's well shot, so I think it's well done, it's good quality. I don't understand people hating it, but once you enjoy the rules or the game and you accept that it is their style of art direction, then I'm pretty sure you will enjoy it. Some cards have this animated or cartoon graphics, but most of them are still pictures of real people, like a movie still image. So militia, these are the events. Militia cards, endurance. Yeah. So mostly these are the characters item. So I think this is what happens to the characters. Yeah. Okay, so let's go to the decks. Specifically for the corners of the map. So on the upper left should be the manor. On the lower right should be the old woods and the abandoned keep. So let's go in that direction. Go to the manor. So the cards inside this manor should be specifically for the manor. So the art should be inside the mansion, so it's inside the house and stuff like that. So here you can meet Jack the servant boy that works in that mansion. There's a secret passage in the mansion, in the manor. Saber. And stuff like that you can find inside a manor. The bleeding wall, meeting of the elders, and stuff like that. Okay. So these cards are made for the manor. Now these are the windmill cards. Let's see, you got attacked, whistling wind, Beast in the Dark, Voodoo Doll. So these are the things you can find in the window. How about in the old woods? What can you find? You get attacked by a ghost, see an axe, see wolves, shallow grave, crossroads, garland, and stuff. Oh, it's Franklin. Franklin Old Hound. Oh, probably my favorite card in the game already. Franklin the Old Hound. In abandoned keep, what can you find? Also, you get attack, a musket, specter,
Collapse, a Rogue's Rapier, a Relic, and stuff. So those are the cards. I think, oh, those are everything. That's everything.
Everything, Patch of Evil. So I'm gonna do one close shot of the components to wrap the video. So just give me a second.
That's the unboxing of Touch of Evil. Thank you for watching. I hope it helped you. And see you again next time.